Was that too much? Yeah.
That's great.
I feel like we spoke a lot.
Yeah. Looking at...
Looking at the camera.
Hi, I'm Ryan. I'm a professor of cybersecurity, and this is Holly, a graduate who's now working in cybersecurity. And we're going to answer your questions.
Ah. Okay, I've got the first question.
Okay.
What is it about UQ's approach that makes us the most employable graduates in the state?
Well, UQ blends the theory and the concepts into actual practice, and you know, its reputation makes it an attractive partner with industry partners. As a result, you get all the graduates experiencing a little bit of the best of both worlds, the best in educating and also the best in the job.
I definitely had that experience. Yeah. Leaving was, I got to go straight into a role, full-time job,
yep,
because I'd done an internship that UQ
exactly
would help me,
yep,
get during my university degree. Yeah.
And then the place that you intern, I guess, have found that you're a talent and they wanted to keep you.
Exactly,
right?
Yeah, so, exactly. And
yeah,
that's the best thing about the internship programs, yep, you know. They
yep
really give you the opportunity to put your toes in the water, you know, before you
yep
go
that's
into
right
industry.
You studied mechatronics, right?
Yes.
Yeah. And now you're working at IBM Security. They're quite different fields, you know. What brought you there and how did UQ's degree in mechatronics prepare you for your current career?
Yeah, so it is a bit of a different path to, I guess,
yeah,
what I thought I was going to do when
yeah
I started engineering. For me, you know, I did mechatronics because I wanted to do a degree that would teach me skills in lots of different areas. So
yeah,
I learned a bit of mechanical, learned a bit of electrical engineering, a little bit of software engineering. And in fact, it was that software piece that let me have an internship at IBM.
Hmm.
And that's how I got a taste for cybersecurity. And I
yeah
followed that from there. And I think that's actually really valuable, you know, in cybersecurity, having those people who have had different backgrounds,
yep,
who think about problems in a slightly different way. So,
hmm,
you know, I probably think about a cybersecurity problem a little bit more from the IoT perspective
mm-hmm
than
yep
someone else might do.
That's right, yeah.
Yeah,
and so that's very, very, very important right now, actually, in this sense. We are moving more towards a dependency on industrial IoT and even industrial control systems, right? So, yeah.
Exactly, and you think about, you know, just our world around us, so much of the physical world
yep
is now being fused with technology. So
mm
cybersecurity really has to become part of everything that we touch.
All right. So what did you learn about yourself whilst you were studying at UQ?
So the main thing I think I learned about myself was just how I learn. And I found that the best way for me to learn
mm
something and to really connect with a topic
yep
is to actually have hands-on experience.
Yeah.
And in fact, I found that after I did a few internships and started working in
mm
industry, I really became passionate about the university work as well
yeah
because I could see how it applied to the real world. And it's when you
yeah
can put it in context and you can see that it's not just an assignment or it's not just
yeah
you know, a piece of work that you have to do. You can see why you were learning that and that made it really valuable. Okay, so what opportunities do your students have to get hands-on experience in our industry?
There are many opportunities. You know, for example, with capstone programs, you know, they can either do an internship like kind of job placement type of attachment at the industry partners. And the other kinds of mechanisms is when we expose them to, say, potential projects in research
mm-hmm
where, you know, the industry guys may have this bugging problem that they want to solve, but they don't have the bandwidth to do that. But it'd be great if somebody, you know, a student and some academics work with them on such longer term problems. So in the end, when the students actually participate in these projects, they get to understand and they get to be mentored by the industry partners. I heard once that, you know, from the feedback of the capstone projects, for example, some of the companies say that it was like getting a consultant.
And I think even the research element, you know, there's so many amazing minds in and around the
yeah
university, having the opportunity to work with those people and learn from people who are absolute experts in their field
yep
is pretty special too.
Yeah, exactly. If you could give one piece of advice, right, to a job candidate, what would it be?
if you're applying for a job, the most important thing you can do is make sure you're prepared for that role that you're applying for. When you're putting your resume together, you want to be ticking the boxes of what that employer is looking for in an employee. So I think really thinking about the role that you're applying for, tailoring your resume, and to do that, you know, you need to have some experience in your area of passion anyway. Yeah. So I think a really important thing is getting involved in not just your university work, but your extracurriculars as well. That's really valuable, so an employer can see that not only you're smart, but that you're passionate about the industry.
And you can do what you say you can do.
Exactly.
And then the experience that you have becomes a portfolio, you know, that shows how good you are,
exactly.
Not just in breadth but in depth.
And I think that's the thing is, if you have the initiative to go out there and to learn these things on your own, not just through mandated courses, you know, it really shows that you're interested in expanding your knowledge about the area, and that's really valuable in a company as well. Okay, so how do you prepare your students for the future when we don't know what the future looks like?
The first thing I want to focus on is always the mindset that they have to be prepared for the time that, you know, they graduate. So if they take a degree, I'll ask them, usually at the beginning of the lectures, just think about, you know, what's the world gonna be like in, you know, in a few years' time when you graduate and you're in the workforce. So that has to be matchmade with their passion. So what are they passionate about? And then they have to align that passion in and mold it into a niche. And then the niche has to align to the ultimate, you know, demand in the market. In another sense about preparing for the future, I think we also want to focus on the lifelong learning aspect. So we tend to try to shape the assignments to have an element of them discovering a little bit for themselves and have the confidence to actually express what they feel about that subject.
And I think in cybersecurity, that's so important to have because the cybersecurity landscape on its own is evolving so quickly.
Exactly.
If you look at the reports each year, it's a completely different type of threat or there's new emerging threats coming out all the time. So those problem solving skills are actually the really important ones to have.
So how did the way you learn at UQ teach you the skills that you need to face an unknown future?
There were a number of skills that I learnt at university which weren't just technical skills. And I think those were really important. In my role now, there's a lot of things we have to do to present and articulate problems to customers or to each other even in the engineering team. Yep. So it's really important to be able to take a complex problem and then be able to boil that down to something that somebody can understand. So, you know, I've traveled around the world with IBM being able to present to customers, and so much of that opportunity has come from the skills that I learned at UQ in presenting engineering concepts.
And that's the approach that UQ is taking actually in a holistic, interdisciplinary way. When we developed our degrees, we intentionally included the non-technical subjects, you know, from political science to criminology, and so on and so forth. So we want to make sure that the graduates actually graduate with a holistic point of view and open to different thoughts so that there's a diversity of thoughts in approaching a single problem.
Yeah, which is really important.
Yep.
So what are some of the coolest jobs your former students are doing?
Yeah, well, there are a lot of very cool jobs.
My job.
Well, they tend to go into, you know, to become leaders in the different roles. So some of my students have gone on to become senior management in the leading security teams that actually support, you know, large customers. So one of my students got into Deloitte, and some of my other students, they had some experience working with the likes of Interpol and a few other prominent organizations. And as a result, before they graduated, they were actually, you know, hired.
Yeah, wow.
So that's another satisfying part of my job.
Yeah. Very cool. Mm.